Hello everyone. Today we are going to start a new chapter, that is calendar. Very important chapter in your competitive exams and very easy one. Just you need to follow the steps that I tell you in order to solve these questions. Now we will solve the questions based on this chapter. So here is the first question that is in front of you. 1 January 2009 is Monday. What is 1 January 2010? Right. So you have to understand that if you do with normal way, what you get 365, right? And you divide it by 7. You might have seen in this book, then you divide after 364. One is remainder. So you add 1, that means it is Tuesday. It is very simple when it is of 1 year. But if I give this gap as 18 years or 20 years, what will you do at that time? You keep doing this into 18, then find out big number, then divide it by 7, then find out the exact number. And if date is something like 13 Jan, even a one day mistake will spoil your answer. So this is not feasible method at all. Whatever I am telling to you, please try to remember that thing. So what you have to do, you have to separate the higher year with smaller year, okay, and the higher number with smaller number, and whatever the is remaining, you have to write it, okay. So suppose 2010 minus 2009, so what is remaining? 1, okay, 1 is remaining. After 1 January and 1 January, if you separate this separate out, that means it comes out to be 0. So 0. Now you have to check whether that is leap year or not, that years. So what you have to do, you have to divide it by 4. So after dividing it by 4, you come to know that this is not a leap year. So you not need to add any extra days. If there is leap year, you have to add 1 extra. Okay. So only 1 you have to add. So how many days it is? 1 day extra. So it is Monday. So 1 day extra is what? Tuesday. Let's see next question. There are a lot of magic we need to do. Okay. In aptitude. Now this question. I told you, separate the higher number with smaller number. So 2010 minus 2005. So 5 is remaining. Okay. So 5 you have to add plus number of leap year that come. So you know that 2000. It's a leap year because last two digit, right, is dividing. 2004 is again leap year. 2008 is again leap year. And 2012 is again leap year. So you not need to see 2000 and 2012 because these are not coming under this, right? And 2004 is also not coming. Only 2008 is coming. So how many leap years are coming in between? Only 1, right? And after subtracting this get cancelled. So this comes out to be 6. So Monday plus 6. So Monday plus 6 means what? Monday is first day. Tuesday will be second. Wednesday will be second. Third will be Thursday. Fourth will be Friday. Fifth will be Saturday. And sixth will be what? Sunday. So 1st January 2010 will be what? Sunday. Okay. Simple. Now here you can see the dates and month both are different, right? So in this type of question, what you have to do is, okay, so what you have to do is you have to first come to the given date, okay, that is 25 September 2006. So what you have to do is you have to make the same month, okay? So suppose you are not going on 25 September 2006, but you are going on 1st September 2006. Okay, in this date you are coming. So if you do this, what will come? You have to separate this with this. So after subtracting 2006 with 2002, how much is remaining? 4, right? And how many leap years come? Only 1, that is 2004, right? Apart from that, what else is remaining? Now you have to come from 1st September to 25th September, right? So how many days are there? 25 minus 1, that comes out to be 24. So plus 24. Okay, leap year you counted. You counted number of years that comes. You counted number of days. Now you can solve 24 plus 1 plus 4. That comes out to be 29. So 29 divided by 7. How much it is? 28 separated. 1 is remaining. So 1 day is ahead of it. That means on 25th September 2006, what will be the day? It will be Wednesday. Simple. If 20 October 2005 is what? If 15 October 2016 is Tuesday. Now you have to go backward. So same thing, just whatever the remainder that is coming, if the remainder is coming 5, now instead of adding 5, you have to separate 5. So you have to go backward, okay? So let's see, 15 October 2016 is Tuesday. So what you do, you have to separate higher with smaller, right? So this comes out to be what? 2000, this comes out to be 2020 get cut. It comes out to be 11. And the number of leap years, 2004 is leap year. 2008 is leap year. 2012 is also a leap year. And 2016 will be leap year. Right. So how many leap years are there? 4 leap years. Right. 4 leap year are there. So you will add 4 plus. Now 15 minus 20. So what this will come? 15, after you mining 15 minus 20, what will it come? Minus 5. So you have to write minus 5 as it is. So 11 plus 4, how much it is? 11 plus 4, 15 minus 5, it comes out to be 10. So after dividing 10 by 7, how much remainder you get? You get 3. So you have to go 3 days. Now where you have to go? In past, right? Back. So you have to separate 3 days. So Tuesday was 0, day 0. So Monday will be day 1 in backward, Sunday will be day 2 and Saturday will be day 3. So Saturday is the answer of this date. Okay, let's move towards next question. Okay, this is the question that if 15 August 2000 is Sunday, what is 5 August 2020? So you have to again do the same, 20 big year minus smaller year. So how much is remaining? 20. Now date you minus. So after date minus, how much you get? Minus 10, right? After doing minus 10 and August get cancelled, so how much is now number of leap year also you have to count. So 2000 is a leap year, but on 29th Feb, this date had not counted, right? Why it has not been counted? Because we took date from what? 15 August. If it was from 15 January, you can count this. But from where they told you 15 August means this day was not included, or this day we never came across, right? 29th February of that year we never came across, so we can't count this day, right, as an extra day, right? So 2004 will be the year which leap year we have to count. 2008 2012 16 and 20 will also be counted, because 29 Feb of 2020 will come, right, by the time of 5 August 2020. So how many days, that extra days that come? 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So you have to add 5. So 15 minus 10, so how much it is? 15, 25 minus 10, so that is 15, right? So 15 divided by 7, how much remainder is remaining? 1. So 1 is what? Ahead you have to go. So Monday, 5 August 2020 is Monday. Thank you.